Hello, everyone. Welcome to this short presentation and explanation about the main degree that we have in computer science. My name is André van Rensen. And before I explain a lot about this degree and all of the wonderful opportunities that you'll have when taking it, I'll quickly explain a little bit about who I am and why you might want to listen to me a little bit. So as I said, my name is André van Rensen. I'm a lecturer at the University of Sydney, and I am also the deputy undergraduate director. I have done my bachelor and master's in computer science and engineering, and I have done my PhD in computer science, focusing on the area of algorithms. I have done this education in various countries, so I am originally from the Netherlands, where I did my undergrad and master. For my PhD, I went to Canada. Then after that, I did a postdoc, so a short research stay essentially in Japan. And now since a number of years, I have been a lecturer in Australia. So I have quite a bit of international experience, which is also one of the things that I think will be of interest to you when I start talking about the Bachelor of Advanced Computing. Am I only a lecturer? No, I'm also a researcher, as basically all academics at the University of Sydney are. And I have roughly 80 publications split between conferences and journals, all in the area of algorithms, so really the area that I have expertise in. But enough about me. That's not what you're here for. You want to learn about the Bachelor of Advanced Computing and what studying at the University of Sydney is like otherwise. So let's get started. The University of Sydney, specifically our School of Computer Science, we are housed in this building over here. And we have a large number of different things that you can learn from us. So our Bachelor of Advanced Computing contains units that are specifically to artificial intelligence, machine learning. There are health informatics if you want to work in the healthcare system or if you want to design systems for them. We have cybersecurity, we have network security, really hot topic at the moment. And all of those things you can study at the University of Sydney as part of our school. Now, what would studying as part of our school look like? Well, our main degree is called the Bachelor of Advanced Computing. This degree is fully accredited by the Australian Computer Society, which is basically just a giant seal of approval from this society saying that this is a good degree, which lots of companies, both domestic and international, just use as basically a vetting system for figuring out if you come from a good university, if you did a good degree or not. So the Bachelor of Advanced Computing has this seal of approval. So basically that makes you immediately very attractive to lots of tech companies, both in Australia and outside of it. This also means that if you want to, for example, go overseas to do research later, again, they will check if you have come from an accredited degree or not. So this is incredibly important. In a bit more detail, the Bachelor of Advanced Computing is a four-year full-time program. And I would very much advise everyone to take it as a four-year program, though there's also an option to basically stop after 3 years and get the Bachelor of Computing instead. I will explain what the differences are between the two in a moment. But basically, what you will do during your Bachelor of Advanced Computing, you'll take a number of what I think of as building block computer science courses, like learning how to program, learning a bit of system design, learning a bit of algorithm design, learning a bit of software development, all those sorts of things. There's also a bit of math to basically build you up to the level that you need to do to analyze some of these things. But basically, your first year is just a lot of the basic computer science that you really need to do any of the more involved and, in my opinion, more interesting aspects of the degree. Then in your second year is where basically the real fun starts. Because in your second year, you will really start to see the specializations of the major that you pick. So the Bachelor of Advanced Computing, if you do this degree, you need to pick a major and possibly a minor to specialize in. We at the moment offer 4 majors, and all of these are available as minors as well. We offer the computational data science major, which basically allows you to specialize in analyzing data, collecting data, basically everything that is really related to big data that companies are gathering on, for example, their customers, and then seeing how you can use this to improve their systems, improve their revenues, all that sort of stuff. We also have a general computer science major, which really delves deeper into computer science as a whole. So that is typically where you get more exposure to more advanced algorithms, some machine learning, some AI. There's a lot of freedom when you take the computer science major. So there are a lot of different things that you can learn from that. Now, the newest major that we have is that of cybersecurity. This is a really, really hot topic at the moment. Companies are really looking for cybersecurity experts. So if you are interested in security in general, this is probably the major for you. What will you learn in this cybersecurity major? Well, it's basically in the name. You will learn how systems can be attacked, how to defend against these attacks, and how to build systems that can just withstand these types of attacks, or how to deal with these attacks when they happen. So really incredibly important topics, especially when you read in the news about data breaches here and there and all that sort of stuff. So as I said, cybersecurity, very hot topic. We have a major specifically for that. So that is very, very interesting at the moment. And our final major is that of software development, where you are basically taught how to develop large software systems. Now, of course, all of these majors share some units. They are related to each other. I mean, it's all computer science, but they each focus on a very different, very specific aspect of computer science. So it really matters which one of these you pick. Now, fortunately, you don't really have to worry about this until essentially your second year, because all of the first year subjects in these majors are already part of your Bachelor of Advanced Computing anyway. So really, these majors start to matter in your second year. So in your first year, you can basically just focus on getting your elementary units right, and just take a bit of time to figure out what area of computer science you're most interested in. And then in your second year, you can just start focusing on the units that belong to that particular major. Now, your major is typically finished after your third year, which is also why at that point we have this early exit option to get the Bachelor of Computing instead of the Bachelor of Advanced Computing. Why would I advise you to take the Bachelor of Advanced Computing instead anyway? Well, because the fourth year is really a very, very good year. It is the year where you take a lot of the advanced units, so really a lot of the specialized units, for example, specializing in AI, specializing in specific algorithms, specializing in human-computer interaction, really the very in-depth units that just make you incredibly appealing for industry. Another thing that you do in your final year is you work with an academic to write an honors thesis. So you join an academic in one of their research projects, and then basically you write down what you found in this research as part of your honors thesis. If you want to afterwards do either a master or a PhD degree, getting this research experience is invaluable. And in Australia, it's mandatory that you take this fourth year before you are allowed to do research in any other capacity. So that is basically the general structure of the degree. What kind of units will be in there? Well, I already mentioned that basically the first year is elementary things, then the second and third year are focusing more on your specializations, and then the fourth year is really in-depth stuff. All of these units are both there to develop your practical skills, but also to develop your theoretical skills, because you need both of these to succeed in the computing industry. So for example, if you end up working at, for example, Google or something, you don't only have to know how to program. You also have to know how to explain to your managers, for example, why what you're building is actually what they asked for, or why your approach is the best one or the most efficient one. So that's why in our degree, we focus on both the practical and the theoretical aspects of computer science. One thing that you might also want to know is that all of our units are taught by people who actively work in that field. So for example, my area of expertise is algorithms, and I teach second year algorithms unit. So basically the units that you take are taught by people that just know a lot about that topic. So you're really learning from the leaders in that particular field. Other than that, your degree is quite flexible. As I said, in your fourth year, there are lots of options for going into depth in specific topics. Your majors allow you to learn a lot about different particular specializations in computer science. So basically, they allow you for a lot of breadth. And then in your final year, you have a bit of research to prepare you for example, a PhD, if you are interested in doing that. When you take the Bachelor of Advanced Computing, it is mandatory that you take one major. You are allowed to pick a second major, either from the list that we have on this slide or from a shared pool that can basically be any major offered by the University of Sydney. You can, of course, also pick a minor instead. That just means that you take fewer units from that particular shared pool, but it will still show up on your transcript afterwards that you know something about this other area as well. So what kind of combinations would you be able to do? So for example, if you take the cybersecurity major and you take the finance major from the business school, you might end up learning, or you might end up with a job where you can, for example, work on keeping banking systems secure or keeping the stock exchange secure. As I said, very important topics at the moment. You can also do things like take the computer science major and then combining that with linguistics if you want to work on something like real-time translation. And there are basically an innumerable number of combinations here. How many combinations are possible? Well, that I don't know for sure, but given that the table S majors that I talked about a moment ago is basically this set of majors, you can understand that there are a lot of very different combinations of computer science and basically any other topic you can think of. So there's lots of choice here, and basically all of these choices will be useful in your future work. Because basically what you can do, or what I typically advise people to do, is look at this table S, think a little bit about what type of industry you might want to end up in, and see if there is a major or a minor that fits that particular industry. So if you want to work for a bank or the stock exchange, it might be good to take a major, like a second major or a minor in one of the business-related topics. Do you want to design systems for architecture firms? You might want to take some design minor or design courses. Because basically, this allows you to learn a little bit about what is going on in that industry, so that it makes it easier for you to talk to your future managers and to your future colleagues, because you already know a lot about your own specialization, but you also know about the things that they typically run into. Now, one of the questions that we typically get when I give these types of presentations is, we see this Bachelor of Advanced Computing and Computer Science, but there's also the Bachelor of Engineering on our specializing in software that is offered by the Faculty of Engineering. What are the differences between these, and why would I choose one over the other? Well, I'll start with just quickly explaining what the Bachelor of Engineering is on just very broad terms. Basically, the Bachelor of Engineering focusing on software contains a number of the units from the Bachelor of Advanced Computing. Specifically, it contains a number of the core units, so really the introduction to programming type stuff, some of the math units, really the background that you're going to need for essentially any kind of computer science degree. Then it contains a number of subjects from the software development major. So not all of them, you don't get the full major, but you do get a number of the units there, because basically the Bachelor of Engineering focuses more on the building of systems, building of hardware systems and software systems. And in order to do this, they also add a number of hardware related units. So think of it as some units that might come from electrical engineering instead. So that's basically the high level idea of what the engineering degree looks like. The major difference between the two is actually in the fourth year, where in the Bachelor of Advanced Computing, even if you take the software development major, you will learn a lot about very advanced topics like deep learning, cloud computing, some natural language processing, depending on which unit you pick, of course. So you're really going in depth into the computer science part. Whereas for the Bachelor of Engineering Honors, you learn a bit more about industry-related topics like quality assurance, industry standards, and engineering management. So that is something that you should really ask yourself what you are more interested in. Are you more interested in the technical side, like really the computer science side of things, or are you more interested in learning the things that you need to go, that you need for like the management type or the quality assurance types if you end up in industry. Now, when you see this slide, it might look like the Bachelor of Advanced Computing is very theoretical, has no links to industry whatsoever, but you couldn't be further from the truth. So one of the things that is mandatory for everyone who takes the Bachelor of Advanced Computing is that in your third year, you complete, as a large group project, what we call the undergraduate capstone project. This is a large computer science project. You typically work in groups of 5 to 6 students. But the most important part is you work with an industry partner to solve one of their actual problems. So specifically, we've had a project with Atlassian in the area of programming and software development. If you're more interested in artificial intelligence or machine learning, you might end up with working with Amazon or Google. Some of the medical related, or so some of the students that do medical degrees on the side as well have worked with hospitals or with Medicare. So really this capstone project allows you to basically get to know industry a little bit. And this is mandatory for everyone who takes our degrees. So you will still get some mandatory industry exposure regardless of whether you take our degree or go to engineering. So the industry part is not a reason not to take the Bachelor of Advanced Computing, basically. What other opportunities do you have to work with industry in our degree? Well, we have summer and winter projects where typically, these of course happen between your typical study semesters. So they happen during the summer and winter break. These projects are fully optional. You do not have to do this, but it gives you a lot of exposure to, again, industry or a bit of research, depending on what project you, you apply for. So as part of these internship projects, there have been projects that work with the Australian government, specifically the Department of Defense. I basically personally run some of these projects as research projects myself virtually every year. So again, this gives you a lot of optional exposure to both research and industry experience as well. And finally, we have an ongoing collaboration with Google, where last year we organized a Google University Research Workshop, where basically final year undergraduates got the opportunity to just experience industrial and academic life a little bit, where they worked on some small projects for, I think, like a day or two. They listened to some talks by people from by academics and people from industry. And basically, that way, they got a really good view of what life after university could look like for them. So this is really, again, a very nice opportunity to just get both experience, but also just a foot in the market, which is going to be incredibly important for you afterwards. Now, you've heard, of course, the usual suspects of the tech firms come up, but where do our graduates typically end up? Well, of course, they end up at tech companies like Google, Microsoft, Amazon. They also end up at various banks. They end up at healthcare providers. Some of them end up at the government. We have people that work at the University of Sydney itself as well. So really, the Bachelor of Advanced Computing, or just computer science in general, gives you a lot of very different opportunities. There's a lot of demand for computer science. This is not about to change as far as I know. So really doing computer science, and specifically the Bachelor of Advanced Computing, will really set you up for a nice career afterwards. And with that, I have basically come to the end of the presentation. If there are any questions, feel free to ask them now or contact us afterwards, and we will be more than happy to help you.
We have a few questions here for you, Andre, in the chat.
Yeah.
So the first one is, will the new cybersecurity major that will be offered to start in 2022 be available in Table S?
That's a very good question. I completely forgot to mention it. Thank you. So some of our majors indeed are offered as Table S majors, so other faculties can also take them. Cybersecurity, however, is not one of them. So if you are interested in taking our cybersecurity major, the only way to do that is to actually take the Bachelor of Advanced Computing. This is mostly because you need a bit more computer science background than you typically get if you come from a different faculty or from a different degree. And for cybersecurity, you just really, really need more computer science background than we can assume if people come from other degrees. So yes, if you want to take cybersecurity, you really, you really just have to do the Bachelor of Advanced Computing.
Oh, thank you for that. The next question is, can the Bachelor of Advanced Computing be combined with other degrees, such as engineering?
There are combination degrees, indeed. So for example, you can combine the Bachelor of Advanced Computing with the Bachelor of Commerce or the Bachelor of Science. Then the four-year program that I talked about turns into a five-year program, because you do have to take a lot of the science units and a lot of the commerce units, of course. But this only adds a single year. Unfortunately, you can't combine it with any other degrees at the moment, mostly because the combinations aren't that nice. Like with science and with commerce, there are a number of units that we already share. So it's a bit easier to combine the two degrees into one, which just simply, unfortunately, isn't the case with most of our other degrees. So yes, you can combine it with some other degrees. Engineering is not one of them.
Thank you, that's good. Finally, what is the maths requirement for admission into the Bachelor of Advanced Computing?
The Bachelor of Advanced Computing has some math prerequisites. If I'm not mistaken, this is Mathematics Extension 1 and or 2, and our units will assume that you actually took those. Are there any other questions?
That's it.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Then thank you all for your attention. As I said, if you have any other questions, feel free to reach out to me or to any of our other supporting staff. Thank you for your attention, and I hope to see you in second year during my units. Bye.